Checky, check.
There we go. We should be. We live. We are live. So as I was saying, we're only going to be streaming the first small section of this game.
This is Banjo-Kazooie made by Rare. We're continuing our Rare love.
So, yep. Ending the stream at 2 a.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Unfortunately.
Might come back to it, though.
Oh, we're definitely coming back to it.
She's just digging right up there. Ooh, yeah, that sound effect. Sounded like a wet one.
Ventilator is actually really disgusting.
Oh, we should read the dialogue. We have Dave with us. Dave is with us here. He doesn't have a mic.
Oh,
but this is cool.
What do you mean? This cannot be. There's no one prettier than me.
Why is Tootie young and small? She's the prettiest girl of all.
No, no, no. You must be mad. Nicer beauty can't be had.
I didn't agree to this.
Unfortunately, I think you'll find it's Tootie. She's cute and kind.
You must be mad.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, rest in peace, sorry. Headphone users.
RIP headphone users.
Well, see about that.
It's a courtesy to Dave as well. He can't read these texts, guys. And in order for Dave to read the text, we have to voice it in very annoying voices. It's the only way it resonates.
Yeah, I skipped. Gruntilda gets Tootie. I skipped this.
I was wondering, I'm like, damn, what just happened?
Yeah, no. Gruntilda comes and grabs Tootie.
Hey, look, it's Marcus.
Just go watch the game.
Better than you can, Goggle Boy.
What was all that noise about? Where's my sister, Tootie?
Oh, the ugly witch Gruntilda swooped down out of the sky and grabbed her.
Oh, fuck that. You're back.
Yes,
no, fuck it. She's a bird. She's a bird. You have to give her that voice.
Mm-hmm. All right, this beginning part is pretty.
It's tutorial.
Yeah. Tutorial. Oh yeah, you don't even. I don't even want to read this shit. It's tutorial garbage. You know how
you
it is.
You bitch. We're gonna you're doing already.
It's Pippa with throat cancer. Everyone.
All right.
I love her.
Here goes all your moves. Are you bastard? You had the moves all along.
Show me your moves.
Trying to remember how.
Do a backflip. Whoa. 10 out of 10. Go. Oh, that
can
carrot
the fast,
has eyes.
The fast run?
No, not yet.
That's after you, right? Right.
Hey! That onion's gonna make me cry.
So we're making our way to Spiral Mountain, so we can fuck off. So we can, go to Mumbo's Mountain. Pippa with throat cancer. So just Pippa. Nice. What's up, Tri Force?
Basically, yeah. Just Pippa. She's at stage 3 now, though. It's not looking good. Her prognosis is bad.
Pippa's transformed into the Kazooie for this game.
Pippa's gonna die tonight. This is gonna be a great one.
This area is awful, a lot like Conker.
It is. The beginning of this is very much like Conker. So you're ready to take the witch.
This is a Conker.
No, you passed that honeycomb piece in the water. I was looking at that.
Is that one of the ones that adds to your life bar?
Yeah, you gotta get those, man. Oh, God!
Hey, he's got Kazooie!
Oh, I like the noise he makes when he falls.
Oh! I thought you said when he evolves. I was like, he evolves?
He does.
Press B. Oh my God. I'm an extra honeycomb piece.
Yeah, like
collect six
saying,
of us to increase
like
your energy bar. Yeah, I feel like a talking tune or something. I don't know. Dave approves.
Go. Don't talk about Shira's wife like that. We're trying to get to the Mumbo Mountain.
Mumbo Mountain.
So, Shira, do you like Banjo 1 or 2 more?
I like 1 more.
Yeah, me too. I believe it.
I think 1 was longer.
I know, there's
more.
There's
a few more, but...
like 5 in each area, I believe.
I felt like 2, I just feel like I just tore through it. I don't know.
There was one underneath the waterfall, but... we only can stream for so long, so...
Yeah, we only got like an hour. This is like an hour stream.
I don't really care about the extra... I'm not going to need them. Well, I might, but... this game's pretty forgiving when you die.
Yeah.
Alright. So, in summary, Dave, she's trying to take the youth from...
is his name Hugo?
Yeah, the other girl.
So, the witch is trying to take the youth away from Tootie, Banjo's sister, to become forever beautiful. And this is Hugo, the servant of Gruntilda.
So Gruntilda has 3 sisters, right?
Yeah. the three witches, the three bitches.
Damn.
The two witches and the one fairy lady, right?
Yeah, or maybe it's just the one sister.
I think it is. No. I guess they're like covenant sisters.
So she always rhymes. If you notice that. Well, Dave doesn't because we're not reading the text.
Yeah, but she's always rhyming.
Evangelo, he got one hell of a power walk. Bro.
Yeah. There's a jiggy.
Yeah, the first jiggy. These are the stars.
Mr. Jiggy. Now go and find a picture with the piece missing. Mr. Jiggy.
The late missing, no.
Yeah.
I forgot my line.
You know, I think the PlayStation version
was kind of
Croc.
The PlayStation versus Croc?
Wait, this is on PlayStation?
No, it's not. He's just saying the PlayStation.
Dude. Don't be saying that.
Yeah, I mean, damn, like.
So the way.
Sure, went like kind of almost hood there. Don't be saying that about Banjo.
So the way this game works is, as you collect jiggies, you can put them into the jigsaw piece or into the puzzle that leads you into new worlds. So like, we have just one missing here. This is the first world. But as it continues, like, you'll be, ooh, world 7. You need 14 pieces of shit.
Yep.
All right.
So it's like bananas, essentially. Like,
yeah, in DK64.
Stars.
But you actually have to, you know, you gotta do some puzzles in this game. There's actual, like, jigsaw puzzles.
The puzzles easy.
I mean, they're easy, but still.
The end boss to
that walk. You need that walk. That walk.
They always fit regardless of the shape. Yeah, no. I think he was referring to.
No, there's some puzzles later on in the game, though, like for bonus stuff, side stuff.
There's your first.
Oh, God, I love these guys. What are they called again?
Jinjos.
Oh!
Yippee! You saved me! So the guild has a prison. Five of us Jinjos on each world. Free us all to get a jiggy.
You're gonna make the same ducky kind of
getting jiggy with it. No.
So each level has a bunch of different jiggies. Fuck off.
Well, that wasn't polite.
And you get them for collecting all the Jinjos, for collecting all the notes. Well, you don't have to collect all the notes, but it's smart too, because that's how you progress to other areas in the hub.
Yep.
It's very much like the star doors in Mario, except for if you open them with coins.
Yeah, I can't believe this game came out in 2009.
Well, sometimes
1998, but...
My eyes got big. Whoa.
Wait, what?
Excuse me?
Really
I actually would also realize that the music notes that you like actually play in the same chord progressions as the songwriter.
Whoa, Mario, wait. Dave's saying some heavy stuff, but you probably can't hear him.
You have to get the one shoot, be able to shoot.
This is where you get the.
I think we have to like bend this mic a little bit more up like that. But you guys, whenever you talk, Dave, the mic's there, so you have to talk into it. You say stuff like that, you gotta kind of talk into it.
So I was saying that the. I was saying that music notes that you're collecting are actually. Well, I was saying the music notes.
You're gonna say that you're not that bright now, aren't you?
Shut up, Shiro. Okay. Music notes.
Wow! If you knew that.
This is a brutal stream.
It
Everyone's
is.
Talking over each other. I'm getting jiggies left and right.
Jiggin. Let's get jiggy with it.
Chimpy hungry.
What were you saying about the?
The music notes that you get are actually playing the same. Like, they're actually playing the same. Chord progression as the music is, so that it's like they go along with the song, like musically. Newer games that do that are stuff like Mario 3D World and
Portal 2.
Land does it. Portal 2. Portal 2, yes, kind of, yes. Sort of. Sort of, but it works a little bit differently.
Killer Instinct, the new one
Killer
on
Instinct,
Xbox One.
Killer Instinct, yes, it does do a similar thing too.
Thank you, Dave. So now we're getting our next move, which allows us to shoot these eggs.
I've always wanted to shoot eggs. Here we go.
Time for the buzzard to learn the ancient ways of the egg. She's like, she hates bottles.
She does.
So to do this, we crouch and then we press Y to shoot stuff, and then you can shoot them out your butt.
Yeah, it's all tutorial crap.
Sounds painful. I wish I never asked. Bird brain carry 100 eggs in their backpack. Eggs that come out of her mouth and butt. Yeah. Yeah. She takes them both ways.
Oof.
Egg sighting, huh?
Oh, right? I don't know. Yeah. I'm a little concerned.
That was like, she's a bird. Just give her eggs.
Where are the eggs?
Where are they going to come out of? Her mouth.
Dang.
Aha, that's what you think.
Yeah, yeah, Mr. Mumble Jumbo.
Wait, how do I fucking stomp? Can I not do that?
You gotta hit you gotta hit Z.
No, that Z is the triggers.
I think it's the move you have to learn
too. Yeah, Bottle knows all the moves. He's like, I got this.
Yeah. Bottle knows his shit.
How do you do first person mode, which is interesting? Because that you could do.
First person mode.
There you go. There we go. Okay. So I can make sure your line's right.
Now you're gonna get that one move.
Fuck, I don't even gotta do this. Whatever.
I think I have to learn the ground.
Yeah.
I know.
We know.
He's a bit bombs. Slippy.
This is why she hates bombs. Oh, yeah, this guy.
I don't worry about him.
That's the same rule for Conker.
Yeah, I think it's actually the same.
Yeah, they're set in the same universe. There actually could be a tie in, but they just. Yep.
So we need to learn how to do the run move to get up these steep slopes, which we're going to learn right now from Bottles after I get this Jiggy and this Jinjo.
Mr. Jinjo! Mr. Jinjo!
Yeah, I would like to see a Bottles.
Damn,
I would like
the
to
Grammys
see,
are tonight. Well, they were tonight.
I'd like to see a Bottles move.
Adele won.
I thought I'd be able to get up that without. Yes! Easy!
Yeah,
easy, breaking sequence.
Silver Skull.
Yeah, those are Mumbo tokens. I'm actually gonna need to get that. Thanks for pointing it out.
Eat them, eat my tacos. 404 my tacos.
Eat them, fuck them.
Eat them. Eat them, fuck them.
Alright, we're gonna go. Bottles is gonna
God,
teach us.
God, this game is not a kid's game.
Bottles is gonna teach us how to do the talent trot.
As you get older, the games mature with you.
The talent trot.
He's like, that sounds useful. How does she do it? And then we're gonna hold the right trigger and press the left trigger. Continue to hold the right or left trigger while moving Kazooie around with the left stick. Go practice. Alright, later. This runs way quicker and is most of
the game uses this.
Said speed yep. Run strats, yep. That sequence break was off the chain.
Yeah, but I'm just gonna do this part first.
I got my music changed. I like that, Dave. What do you think about that audio change? Yeah, Gex is slept on. I'm gonna play Gex on stream, guys. All of them.
All of them. Gex
is everyone. Everything. Gex. Gex 3. The one where he was a secret agent. It was like James Bond.
Yeah, Gex 3 was awesome.
I like the one where he went to Cartoon Land.
Yeah.
Yeah, when he went to the different scenarios.
Yeah, different TV stations.
Yeah.
That game was dope.
Actually, I have that game.
You had to collect. No, you do?
I have Gex 1.
Well, I'm like. Nice. I want to play Gex. Yeah, that's super rare, dude. You're sleeping on it, dude. You could be rich right now. I know.
I don't have like the case or anything, but I have the case.
Dude, that game's worth. Dude, that game's worth $9,000. You want to, dude? That game is super rare, dude.
Picking up jiggies like a crazy.
You are crazy though. They do. This is a true story. They call Matt the Jigga Man everywhere he goes. He doesn't know why.
Come on, that was right in your face, dude.
Take the fucking eggs!
Thank God.
That was an interesting motion tween.
It was like
the animation, like the enemy just like flew off the screen, just shrunk.
So Bottles is now gonna teach us how to ground pound, because the beat buster, jump into the air, and then press the right trigger, or left trigger, to send Kazooie plummeting. Hard down.
Hard down.
Yeah. Gulp. I don't like the sound of that banjo. Bottles and Kazooie are in like this really weird abusive relationship.
Yeah.
And he's like, I can't teach you anymore in this world. And I'm like, I know. So now we're gonna go ahead and.
You know what I think about Rayman?
Whoa.
Rayman. I like Rayman.
Yeah.
The Great Escape.
I like
Rayman too. Yeah. I
played them all, but I just don't remember.
I like the Origins or.
Oh yeah, Legends and Origins are sweet.
What's that? What's the one with the axe girl?
Origin.
It's an extra life.
It's Origins or Legends.
It's Legends, I thought.
Yeah.
Legends of
I get them confused. It's like Oracle of Ages and Seasons. Right?
Oracle of Augies.
Oracle of Augies.
Like Legends because you got the musical runs at the end. Like Origins, like most of the levels are in music.
Yeah, yeah, it's very much with the rhythm of the.
But yeah. Legends is the one where you got the runs at the end. Where you got a.
So this is Mumbo. Mumbo is the shaman who he changes
the shaman
into,
in all game.
He changes you into animals.
Can't help Banjo and Phil J. Found that
no one really likes Kazooie. It seems. Yeah, Mumbo's magic tokens, like really hid by witch. Find tokens and Mumbo help you.
Damn.
Got enough.
That's what it is. It's just sexism. Misogyny.
So we need one
Gamergate.
More. Gamergate. Zoe. Yeah, I was backing up so I could.
Brought to you by Five Guys.
Wait, Marcus, you said, like, in Banjo.
That's Origins.
The Rayman Legends, like the one with the axe girl. The end of like I guess you could say the chapters. They each got their own like musical like runs at the end where you're more of just running to the music.
Follow with the beat.
Follow the beat basically. Yeah.
It's a rhythm based like platforming.
They had something like that in Rayman 2. Like you had to like follow these like.
Musical paths and it kind of like fell off.
I think it was Rayman
3.
Yeah,
I'm.
It was
Rayman 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd be down for that.
You hear that, kids?
You know that Rabbit Rabbit crap? That came from Rayman. It did. It definitely did. And then Mario Rabbit Rabbit comes out.
They had a TV show for Rabbit Rabbit.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I actually watched that. My buddy, his daughter likes it. Well, she's a baby, so I guess he likes it. But
isn't it kind of like the Minions, though?
Yeah, it's like Minions, but funnier, to be honest.
Minions, but funnier?
Yeah, it's Minions,
but that's not hard to do.
It's Minions, but good. How is it funny? I don't know, Dave. Maybe it's not funny to you, but it's funny to me.
Like, what is the fucking Goodfellas scene? How is it funny? Explain to me, man. How the fuck do you mean it's funny?
So I'm a funny guy.
What do you mean it's a funny show? Like it's a fucking clown show?
Do I amuse you?
It's a show. What? It make you laugh?
I'm just fucking with you.
Oh, just fucking.
And then you fucking.
Yeah, I shoot you.
Fucking look in my eyes when you die, motherfucker.
Yeah, look at my eyes. Start to piss me off.
Oh God.
Shiro, shut up. Oh, Dave.
Oh my God.
Yar. Oh fuck.
Yeah. That was nice.
I'll watch the show. Yeah.
It's like SpongeBob. They have like 3 segments per show. I mean, it's decent.
It's more like slapstick.
It's slapstick, yeah.
Is it like old Looney Tunes?
No.
Old Looney Tunes, Dave?
I actually did like Old Looney Tunes.
Interesting. You like Three Stooges?
I don't know how I feel about this Space Jam remake.
I'm not really there watching.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's really a Space Jam remake.
Bear
guys.
Beat Conga. Me give price to Bear. Thanks. Give me true. That jiggy. Give me that
Shiro's
jiggy.
Back there spreading blasphemous lies out of his mouth.
There's
mouth is flapping.
There's supposed to be a Space Jam 2. It's supposed to be a Space Jam 2.
With LeBron.
LeBron James?
Yeah, that's what they always say.
Yeah, You can't get this anybody to do this. Your hair's running away from you. Poor LeBron.
His hairline.
It is gone, dude. You should see it now.
See how far I can get up. Right. We got the final Mumbo token, so we're gonna go over here. We're gonna turn into a animal and finish this animal. World.
We're gonna Digivolve.
We're gonna Digivolve. But first.
Andrew's sister kind of looks like Coco a little bit.
But first.
Who's Coco?
From Brown.
Oh, you're right. It's like this is like a prequel, because Coco's a little bit older.
I guess so. Yeah.
I like getting up on top of here.
Oh, I'm so sorry. He's like, you did it right.
I like getting up here.
She's so much more beautiful. We're about to get the furries in here.
All right, shh, quiet for this transformation. I want to feel it.
Banjo his pretty tokens. Stand on skull and press X to see a mighty Mumbo magic. Ooga,
let's go, guys.
I can fuck him.
Yay!
Oh, now you're a man.
Digivolve into an
Mumbles magic, free to change back. Will come when ready. Termite bite small.
Eat a termite.
See, it's essentially the same thing except one eats wood.
Termite man.
Just the first world. We did the first world in 20 minutes.
Termomanum.
Maybe we're going a little bit further.
Termomanum.
Give me those shots.
I like that he always has the, like, each animal has the little backpack. Yep. It's really cute.
Give me those shots, you little bitch.
Whoa! What is going on back there? Oh, all 100 notes in this world. Look at you, you're on a roll. You're speedrunning.
Yeah, I know this game pretty good in the beginning.
Yeah, I remember I didn't get lost in this game until later when I was a kid. I got lost during the part where, I forget what world it was, but it's one where you kind of got to go off the beaten path and you have to like go around. It's like by the, it's right after the underwater section. And I just remember getting lost for a long time. It was like a Halloween town or some shit. It was weird. It was like a horror level or something. It's so hard to find is what it was. It took me a while to find it. I found it, and then I was like, holy shit.
That level was actually
That was the only time when I got lost in this game.
I was stuck
is that Spyro? They look like they're related to Spyro.
Yeah, it's outside.
We gotta play Spyro on it, too.
The one with Elijah Woods, right?
Oh, that's right. You can't do that.
Cause yeah, I saw that one with Elijah Woods. I was like, dude, that looks sweet. Like, I got Elijah Woods. He's like a Hollywood actor.
That probably does have a family, so.
He has a family.
Totally
credit,
but, I mean, we play that one too.
I should just play that one. That's probably the best one. I mean, it's got Elijah Woods in it.
So you can only be an animal in a certain radius to the entrance.
Amazing.
All right, we move on. Easy first world.
I feel like you're gonna have a repeat of Avatar. You're gonna play and you'll be like, this is not good though.
Ugh. Well, that's the case then. That's the case, and I guess Spyro just wasn't good.
Alright, Bottles is gonna tell us we need 50 notes. This is a note door. Open up and then jam jars. It's not that simple to open it. You must collect the musical notes from the worlds.
Triforce is just like Spyro the Dragon. Do you like it, Triforce?
Well, you were talking about Spyro.
Well, I'm just saying, what's he saying it for? Are you a fan?
Man, Spyro the Dragon's a good game. We should try
Triforce.
We've been talking about streaming that for a minute now.
Literally a minute. It's the only time I've heard it ever been uttered.
No, we talked about it. Remember, he was like, he has all the, Dave said he had all of them on PS3. Because we were talking about.
Oh, I thought it was Ape Escape was the one he wanted to stream.
I mean, I like to stream that too.
So we need 50 notes to open this.
Why don't we have? You know, we should need to start doing. We should start doing like appreciation weeks or something, like appreciation. Like, so one week just be like platformers.
Oh, there's your sister.
So you talk to her. This is Gruntilda's sister.
Nobody knows this enemy now.
We have to talk to her because she tells us facts that we're gonna use later in the game. It's Gruntilda. Gruntilda's nicer sister. She crept down here to help us defeat her. And yeah, we're gonna need these factoids for a later end
these
game
really
mission.
Important,
yeah. If you know them, you can kind of guess them. But
these are important because of in-game.
So we have to remember them
Yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, these are important.
A fiery fate. Press X if you'd like to hear them. All right. So the first one is that Grunty brushes your rotten teeth with salted slug-flavored toothpaste. Second one being that she also washes her hair with rancid milk.
Mm-mm-mm.
And third fact, and she gets her clothes from the witch's war hair.
What's wrong with that?
Oh, nothing specifically.
That last part there seemed a little classist, I think.
I don't like trying to choke.
I mean,
here's the puzzles.
Don't like
this is the worst level in this entire game.
I don't like trying to choke Cove. You know what? I'm gonna not go there.
Oh, I remember this with the shark or whatever.
Yeah, fuck this. I don't like trying to choke Cove at all.
I hate it. It's literally one of the worst levels in this entire game.
Let's see if I can go to another. I'm probably not going to be able to go to third world.
This is
when I think it's like 120.
This is when the stream dies.
Yeah, that was a level in Diddy Kong. So these are warp pipes. I don't really use them. They're cauldrons. You jump in one, it'll take you somewhere else. Wow. I really came back here for the Momo token. But yeah, so we found the other one, and then we can warp around the overworld.
Wow.
Jumps are better.
That's pretty good. I can't do that sound.
god, I hate this
one. Oh, this isn't man. As bad. I'm just gonna go grab. Oh, fuck off.
I'm not gonna say I hate it.
No, the one with the big ship is definitely the worst.
Whoa.
Alright. I came back, got that mumbo token.
What if you like were on the phone one day and you can't also like on a customer and just talking like that?
Well,
what would you do?
I would.
What would you do?
I was like that show.
Yeah.
What would you do if someone was calling you at your job, really wanting to know?
I really don't want
to
go do this.
The name of you, it rhymes with doom, what? And you're gonna be hurting all too soon.
That was the Triforce. Riddle, Triforce posing. Motherfuck! I looked at the thing and
that was actually from.
It was Dragon Ball.
From Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah.
I'm not a huge proponent of Dragon Ball. I've watched quite a bit. 180. Fuck really, me yeah. Sideways. So my favorite level is actually over here. I just want to go over here because I want Dave to hear the music. It's my favorite music in this entire game. It's called Click Clock Woods. Yeah, the puzzle's over here, but it's not so one of the last worlds. But just listen to this music, Dave. I think they play the overworld music here. Not this, but this.
The second to last.
Will it play? Yeah, this is it.
Click Clock Wood.
Yep. Alright, we're gonna learn from Brent Tilda.
Learn from the best.
Ugly Grunty's nickname was Hog Breath at which school?
What?
I also know that freshly burst boils is her favorite smell.
Ooh.
And the old hag's favorite color is gruesome green.
What is gruesome green? Can we see that?
It's green with like a little bit of blood probably in it.
Mm. No. Oh, you look at that.
Yeah.
Well, you're like, yeah.
Yeah, baby.
I love gruesome green.
I love
gruesome
green. The gruesomer the better.
Alright, so now we're gonna go to this fucking world that's gonna take me way longer than 20 minutes.
Hey.
No, Woods, the puzzle is there, but it has a lot of puzzle pieces we're gonna need to fill it, and also, it's not until one of the last worlds that we can access. Can I please? Oh, whoops. Oh, I'm stupid. I just want to do this. Oh, you hit something in the overworld. I know this game too well, and I'm starting to be like,
why do you do that?
Isn't there a Mumbo token? No, I'm tripping. Okay.
There's a little blood in it. You should get that checked out.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Alright, here's fucking Treasure Trove Cove.
My favorite level.
The best level.
This
please
is
get out of the water! Please Jaws get out of the water! Here he is! There he is!
Alright, now I just want to activate him.
God, I hate him! It did scare me. A lot. Especially how he just appeared.
Yeah, he's kind of okay. That's what I need to do. Alright!
That's what scared me about Dungeons
64.
Like, I would jump in the water, and
they
start playing this dark
energy
music.
I'm
like, whoa, go back.
Same with
fucking
Jack, dude. Like,
yeah, Jack used to scare it out. Scared. And, like, you had no. It just come out of nowhere. Nope. I mean, Ratchet Clank did that, but it was so quick and Ratchet Clank, you didn't even think about it. Like, oh,
I'm not going in the water.
I mean, that happened as well.
He doesn't want your butthole. Stop it.
He's coming for your butt. The delicious butt.
He's coming for the booty.
Who's coming for
you? All right, Bottles is going to teach us the high jump.
Booty's more important than water.
With shock jump spring. Don't worry, the turkey does all the work. Simply stand on the shock jump disc and then press and hold A. Your energy's a little low. Let's fill it up. Thanks. All right, I'm going to do...
Bottles is legit.
Oh man, what should you do first?
I don't know, there's so much shit.
Yeah, so much fucking
this is when the game opens, I was like, what's going on?
Excuse my language, guys. But...
Excuse my language,
this has been such a you clean stream.
I'm sorry, it
sorry, guys.
It pisses me off.
I don't want to offend anybody on this stream.
I don't know, that's just
Is it the pirate ship?
It's just that there's so much shit to do.
So much back and forth.
Mumbo's Mountain has this nice like little like, okay, go here, grab this, grab that, and this is just all back and forth. Especially the note placement is super obnoxious.
You'll see, he's gonna be doing this level for quite a while.
Yeah. See, for me, it's just, I don't really like pirates, so I'd be like, man.
Well, that too, it's not like the best thing.
The only pirate I like is Guybrush Threepwood.
Hell yeah.
I don't know if you guys know about him, but.
Yeah, that monkey eye. This is your big chance, chicken legs, it's time for you to fly!
Did you play the 3D Mario?
Yeah.
Which one?
Escape from Monkey Island.
Oh, yeah. Hmm? Yeah, I'm a big fan of Monkey Island 1 and 2. Hmm, your energy is a little low. I'll fill it up. Thanks, bud. Why come to you?
Dave's wondering about the Longest Journey series, if you guys can't hear.
It sounds familiar, but I don't think I've played it.
Yeah,
but
you want to be a Longest Journey
fan.
Oh,
Dreamfall I played, yeah.
Yeah, that was a sequel.
That was on Xbox, wasn't it?
Yeah. Man, that one was a lot easier.
Oh my god.
Never played him.
So this is Captain Blubber, and he lost his treasure when his ship crashed.
Such a crack.
So we're gonna go find it for him. He can't swim, which is kind of funny because he's the captain of the ship. So we're gonna go ahead and, go into the ship.
He's what?
He's a hippo.
He's a manatee?
Yeah.
What the hell kind of manatee is that?
He's a hippo.
She was like, okay, you're gonna see when he takes his hippo suit off.
Is why you wearing that silly hippo flippers. Suit?
Next thing you know, he's trying to get your goods.
Alright, we're going down.
Damn, Mark, you got something against hippos or manatees or something?
Can I just get the gold? There's also quite a bit of swimming in this one.
Yeah, swimming really just drags the game down.
I mean, in these early rare titles, yeah, it's not the best.
Yeah,
Donkey Kong did it good. Take it, stop crying.
Oh,
throw it at you.
Lot the half of me gold.
You have something against hippos, man.
I just want to say that was a really clean jump, guys. That was really nice. Otherwise, you have to normally have to swim down and enter that hole, but it did it with the. Yeah, dude, this is bad. All right, come on. There we go.
The bane of the 1990s and early 2000s.
Cameras.
That's still a thing now.
Back then, you just had a bane. Back then, you just had to grin and put up with it, though.
Yeah. All
right. We got it.
Well, back then, you didn't have dual sticks.
Yeah.
N64? Oh, man.
I think the thing that pisses me off about this level the most is the note placement, for sure. There you go, give me the jiggy, dude.
I think that's what I liked about Mario 64 was, like, the bad camera angles could be forgiven because it was a bad camera, man.
Yeah, that's worth quite a bit. Mm-hmm. That's worth some real cash. Cash dollars there.
Dalla dalla billia! I mean, clearly that's exactly what happened. Accessories.
He probably stole that treasure.
I mean, there's a lot of games where if you think about it, you're kind of the bad guy.
I love this part.
All the damage you do. A lot of collateral damage.
Why did you do this right now?
Because I felt the need. No, I want to get the note. I was going to do this part because it's annoying.
Of course, it's like, Zarkus, you got a problem with one of my exes? She isn't that big. Okay, she is. I don't chat, man.
Zarkus, you got a problem with one of X's? She ain't that big. Okay, she is. That's what Triforce just said.
Did that beef? Starting that beef? He's getting ready to go to bed over here. He's napping out.
We're gonna get this ginger.
I'm pretty tired myself. I'm surprised I'm still awake. What? When did your project do? This guy's got a project due. Wednesday. Wow, they just keep getting Tuesday. Monday just keeps getting sooner. Now. Oh, it's past due.
4 hours.
Oh, man.
Guys, I think I'm fuck up.
I think I'm flunked out.
He's seen Mumbo Mountain. He doesn't care about any of this shit, let me tell you.
Right, yeah.
Mumbo Mountain.
Right, we said Mumbo Mountain. We saw it.
He could have just opened that damn door.
Yeah, you need to destroy
it.
Alright, there we go. That's how you get the jigsaw.
Everything you do, I'm like, you could have did that different.
You could have did that different. You just like criticized everything. Like, you pull inside, banjo, what the fuck was
that?
Yeah,
see, this is what I don't like. There's note placement. And you see, if I didn't remember to come back and grab these three notes on these platforms, you don't have to get to. I would have been walking around with 97 notes at the end of the game going, where the fuck am I? So we're gonna grab this jiggy. It's yeah, Spyro. Like 999 gems out of 1,000. Come on.
That makes it worse. It's like that one gem out of this old big ass world.
Yeah, that's when you need something like a Dragon Radar type deal. Because at that point, it's stupid. It's not even a fun gameplay.
Sitting like really
water level, just like half almost like, oh, where is it? Especially like a really hard level,
was
like later in the game.
I used to jump off there and
listen
to
him scream.
Yeah,
wow!
But I don't
want to
die.
Wow! I don't know if you guys heard that. Sure, I used to just jump, make him jump off there and listen to him scream.
Trying to decide where I want to go.
Like that was terrible. That's terrible. Right? Like man, when AI. Oh man, this who knows. It has AI, guys.
No,
it has some
come on.
Who knows? Maybe it has some feeling.
Got the same idea. It starts off as a video game.
Right.
And then there's a red light. It's perfect.
I fucking nailed it. I fucking fall on the platform I need to get to.
First of all, you can get Marcus on the top of a damn building. I guess that third floor, like, where the fuck we going?
Yeah. Why are we going so high, Shiro?
Why are we going so high?
You live on the third floor. Not the fifth.
What's up on the top floor, Shiro? I ain't going up there.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it'd be a fun game of Clue if you're watching this archive and one of us is dead. You know, figure out who murdered who. We're starting to kind of unravel some motives here.
Impossible. I landed here from the top, which is what I wanted to do, because I'm going to do this shit.
Banjo-Kazooie's version of our movie.
Got the jiggy.
Yeah.
Can you stop for one minute?
Real.
You're like,
you're
gonna make the most crazy
version of that. Is that not? It's not like that scene for Dumb and Dumber. You want to hear the most annoying sound in the world? Like, that's what this is gonna turn into. Yeah, right. No. That's what this is gonna turn into.
That,
who can make the most obnoxious version of that laugh?
Oh, alright.
That was an orca.
It's the blue whale.
Yeah, that was crying. Yeah. That was, go to bed.
Oh my god. Oh, that was no.
That was Pippa. That was Pippa.
What is that?
Pippa needs to go to sleep.
That was Pippa. Pippa's everybody, man. Pippa's cow, man.
She ain't me.
Pippa is life. Pippa is.
Pippa's life. That's gonna be our first Pippa's life shirt.
Jesus Christ.
Merch. Space Brain merch.
Dude, we gotta get like artists to draw like Pippa, but like kind of like you draw like the toes and like kind of cough over the toes out like.
Oh no.
Kind of like Pippa is life. Pippa like the Ian Space Brain joke.
Yeah.
Yes, it is like looking for the final Zygarde cell in Pokemon.
So this part is super awesome.
Remember back in the day when Nintendo had that hotline?
Which
winner of best
hip-hop song?
Best
hip-hop song, Grammys 2017.
All right, this part is actually how you put in cheat codes.
Yep.
But we're not doing cheat codes. We're doing.
It's backwards, isn't it?
Never trust a black cat.
Racist.
Oh no, you're right. This one is.
Yes,
he's my favorite color though.
They
black
have
and red.
On the wall in case you're stupid.
Like he's like black and salmon.
There it is.
Yeah, I guess.
I'm getting technical.
I guess you're getting technical. I guess. Yeah, this is more black and red. What you got going on? That might be. Yeah. You're criticizing everything. You're grouchy when you're tired.
Very.
Why'd you do it that way? That's salmon, Cal.
It's fucking salmon. Salmon.
There's 50 shades of red. Okay, that's salmon. Shade number 39.
Be like he's selling paint samples at the
yeah, right.
Home Depot or something.
Yeah,
like fucking
pulled off the slides. This is what it is. This one, slide 37, salmon. Pulled out a fish. Look at the salmon.
I remember any of the
red paint? Red.
Pippa is life.
What do you mean red?
Pippa is love.
Pippa is love.
So yeah, you can put in like some passcodes to get you unlimited red feathers, unlimited infinite feathers, unlimited eggs.
I remember. I remember you could turn. You could play as a washer machine.
Wait, yes, that's part. That's later in the game. Yep.
You play as a washer machine.
Yep.
Dude's probably like, guys made that up.
It's very
but no, I really didn't.
You
make
see how
that
he disappears? You see how he disappears?
Got that Oscar?
Yes.
Boom, 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 boom,
boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, boom, bo This music is actually from Donkey Kong. The boss battle.
I know. I'm pretty sure you use a lot of the same instruments.
Well, Donkey Kong used these.
Wait.
This actually came out before it, but
this isn't in the first one. This is Stop and Swap shit, isn't this? Is this? I don't remember this part at all.
I think this is in the first one.
I think this is Stop and Swap stuff. So, Stop and Swap was a... Here's a fun fact. When they were first making this game, they had features that, depending on if you had completed things in Banjo-Kazooie 1 or other rare games, that you could transfer them over to Banjo-Kazooie 2 in a feature called Stop and Swap. And that's because N64 carts... Well, the N64 system would retain some data from a cartridge if you ejected it and pulled it out while the console was still on. So the idea was that they would save some data from, like, Banjo-Kazooie, and then when you put in... Yep, when you put in Banjo-Tooie, like, if you collected the Stop and Swap thing, took out your cartridge and put in Banjo-Tooie, you would have something in the second game. But then Nintendo was like, hey, you shouldn't do that, because it might fuck up people's cartridges. And they took it out last minute. In this, it's essentially you just collect 7 eggs and you get stuff from Nuts and Bolts, or for Nuts and Bolts. But.
Hmm.
Yeah, because it wasn't until the Xbox release that it lined up.
Okay, so like, wait, just kidding. I like the first download content.
Yeah.
So this game for the Xbox 360, you get stuff from Nuts and Bolts.
Yeah, but in the original game, it was originally planned that if you found those eggs, you would get stuff for Banjo-Tooie or other rare games, but since it potentially could damage your cart, they had to take it out last minute. They made the entire feature without telling Nintendo that they were going to do it. And then they're like, hey, we have this thing called Stop and Swap. And Nintendo's like, no, you don't.
I don't think so.
You're not going to be breaking a cartridge for that.
Yeah, because, and there was also, depending on the console, there was no guarantee that the stuff would transfer. It was like a glitch in one of the hardware.
So it could technically break the game.
It could both technically break the game and not work if you had bought the N64 that fixed that issue. Yeah, so it was just, but it's a fun little thing. In the original game, the reason that people know about it is because in the original game, there is a place where you, in like an ice dungeon, where you need a key, kind of, to get there. But it's not in the game, because it was literally taken out like a few weeks before they shipped. Hmm. Alright, so this is fun.
Fun fact. I didn't know that.
This is great.
Didn't know that at all.
Yes. Get on here.
I wonder if new games have really interesting little things like that.
I mean, yeah, it's most of them are hidden in production stories. The only reason that came to be was because they left some stuff. Motherfucker. They left some stuff. This part's annoying because if you get hit, you fly back. Potentially lose the jiggy. Go-huh.
The booty.
I'm saving the crab man for
that. That's one nice check.
Oh, yeah.
And this.
Dave said that's a nice texture. I agree.
Get out of here. Are you ready? Are you ready?
What?
Oh, no, because, oh, no.
Oh.
Dun, 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 dun. Oh, come on, you're not going to do speed box.
Don't do speed
on the
box.
I was like, nope.
Well, I'm floating.
I'm doing it.
I'm
a boxing, I do what
that's
I want.
That's what the music, that's the sound of it. Boom, 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 boom.
I'm gonna call that Shark Dave. I just feel like that's like Dave.
Shark Dave?
Yeah.
What are you doing in here?
I don't know. You get it, because I feel like if you get in Dave's water, that's how he'd be.
Yeah, okay.
You're not supposed to be in here. Hey, get out of here.
Hey, get out of here.
Yeah. You can have that
what
little
you doing here?
You can...
Shut up, Banjo.
The shark is actually... You can escape him, like, when that happens. When
oh, wow. Your pathfinding sucks, Dave.
But also...
Well, that's because I'm stuck on old generation hardware.
But
can't
also,
even navigate around a box. That's why you got the origin. This is an origin story. Stop being a box! That's why Dave calls it...
If you jump at the right time, you can just completely avoid the shark, and there's no big issue. All right, we got this. I think it's just a...
What?
Oh, playing this game.
yeah, good point.
Oh, I'm gonna get hit. The shark was pretty scary until you figure out that you can just like.
I was more afraid of like the eel in Mario 64.
Yeah,
yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
That thing freaked me out.
Same idea.
The piano was still my biggest fear.
Oh yeah, the piano.
That was like a jump scare. That was like a legit jump scare when the piano started.
Transformation Central.
Transformation Central.
grab this extra life.
Don't blame me.
You can blame Space Brain, the musical. Fuck. Gamer picture unlocked.
Yeah, that Xbox 360 arcade shit.
What is that from?
Princess and the Frog.
Never seen it.
Uh-huh. Nice. Hell yeah, we're all in it together. Alright, I'm wondering if I've accurately collected all these notes, except for the,
I gotta think we should,
yes.
I really think we should try Poi.
What?
Poi?
P-O-I.
Poi is a game that was released pretty recently on Steam that was heavily inspired by games like this. It has very similar graphics, but just updated to current-gen graphics. And, pretty much an open-world, collect-a-thon, platformery type of game.
It's a good time.
I mean, I'll check it out.
Yeah.
I mean, Dave, get it. We'll play.
I will.
Don't worry, I will. That sounds like it's probably not gonna happen, guys. That was very,
No, it was more like that. Oh, dude, don't worry, I will.
Oh, okay.
Alright, here's this great part that I love totally. It's awesome. This is a giant
Nipper is a weird name.
Nipper's Beach.
What is wrong with his eyes?
Those are just normal eyes, Dave. That's how
why you gotta be hey?
Yeah, that's just the animal. So you jump up and you poke his fucking eyes out.
Oh god!
You avoid his attacks. Sick attack.
Like, you hurt Nipper.
And he's like, I'm gonna get you, and you're like, not even close once, buddy. And he's done. Alright.
Oh, so rude, man.
Yeah, he gives you a lot of problems because unless
but
you
But he's in there. That's why I never got.
Alright.
He escaped out of back door.
Yeah, right.
Is underground. All of the notes. Yes. We're so fucking done with this.
Did they rob you while you were in there?
They better not. Yup.
You ever notice how you massacre those crabs and they body parts just fly
around? It's pretty brutal, actually. How many is that?
Yeah, I was like, I don't know where this is going.
Oh my god, where's this going?
Please stop.
Just the last one.
Cut the feed.
We gotta finish the treasure. The treasure hunt. Yeah.
The treasure.
Don't worry, Triforce. I know this for these first few worlds. Once we get to Clanker's Cavern, that's when I'm gonna start losing it.
Clanker's Cabin.
Conker's Cabin. Conker's Cabin. Cabin Adventure.
Conker's
Cabin.
Oh boy. I don't know about that.
So you want some green stuff?
Too bad Project Spark is dead. You could have made us some Conker levels.
Yeah, Project Spark crashed and burned.
Right after Conker came out, actually.
Yeah, the Conker thing, I think they gave that away for a while, and then I didn't even download it. Because I was like, meh.
That was so sad.
It was.
Project Spark was a nice little engine. I liked it.
I played a little bit. It was pretty neat.
Alright, we're going. We're finishing this treasure hunt at Treasure Trove Cove. I can talk. Surprisingly did this level in 30 minutes.
You didn't hit it.
Oh, I didn't? Okay, it's fine. I'm gonna grab this mumbo. Oh, wow. Alright.
Hit.
Collision.
Damn.
Oh, you're being rude. Alright, not important. Okay.
It's okay,
man. It's okay, man.
Brah!
Don't go fuck you. Fuck you, eat you.
Do you have beer? I'll just take the beer.
Motherfuck!
Ain't that a...
The head went through it.
Missed that.
It was like, no.
It was like, oh, you almost got us. You're so maybe close. Next time you give me a beer.
Give me a beer.
Haha,
you'll never find me now.
I know where you are.
And I south?
He's right here.
It's like... I don't know, what's that guy that does the Toy Story song?
You got a friend! Yeah.
That's what it sounded like. I'm like
Randy,
Randy Newman! There we go, Randy Newman. I was like, why is Randy
you
Newman?
You got your troubles!
Why is Randy Newman a treasure chest?
You got a friend in me!
But dang, dang, dang.
You got a friend in me!
When the road looks
rough ahead and bears! Bears from your nice warm bed!
But I'm in a bear!
Just remember what your old pal said, boy. You got a friend in me.
Oh, someone got troubles and I got them too. There ain't nothing I wanna do for you.
Oh, Jesus.
That's the second verse, my dude.
No.
Come closer, my name's Randy. My name's Randy. Hop in my van and eat all this candy. It's the jungle out
where's
there.
Where's your mom and where's your dad? I'm your uncle. Come with me, Randy.
There's a jungle out there.
Yeah, the monk theme song as well. It's the only two songs I know of him. Monk and Toy Story.
What if Randy Newman did Tarzan?
Oh, God.
All right.
Tell me more. I want to know about the strangers like me.
Oh, Bubba.
This is like a scary song now. Yeah, a little bit. A little bit. I'll be scared.
Scares her.
Come in my van, I got all this candy. You might have heard of me. Toy Story's Randy. You like that movie? Well, I like it too. Get in my van, stop screaming.
I was like, this can go to really bad places. I like a lot of things that rhyme with that. Let's see where he goes.
Here's another one. Brent Tilda. My lazy sister often sleeps on a pile of treasure. The dirty hag.
Oh my god.
The only thing she ever won was the biggest butt competition at which school?
What? Damn.
She's nope. Thick.
She's thick. Oh,
she often boasts of appearing on the cover of Fat Hag Monthly, posing in her long johns.
Hey, big girls didn't know too.
Yeah, man, now we're just body shaming.
Question.
Who's the real villain here? Who's the real villain?
We're gonna go to one of my favorite levels.
Yeah. Whoa, that was
the
nice.
The caveman from Conker.
Oh, I can't use those yet.
Wow. Was that back then?
Is that you need the level or is it? Oh.
I'm here, love.
Tilda. My fat old sister's favorite sport is loogie flicking. Although she's dim, she's attended St. Dungball's school. Well, that's cute. You won't believe that Gruntilda's party trick is shoving, performing a scary striptease.
That almost is just bad.
Gruntilda is that kind of. You guys want to see what I can do with this bottle?
Whoa!
It's like Gruntilda. Gruntilda, it's 6 in the morning.
Yeah.
You're by a school.
Stop it.
By a school.
All right,
oh,
we're gonna.
God.
Yeah, I think we have to go to Gobi
Goose.
Gobi Desert to
stop.
Do this. So, yeah, we need to go to Gobi Gobi Desert before we do this.
Yeah, that's how you go.
I wanted to do this level. It's my favorite. There's a little crocodile family where you sing along with them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the best part. It's not the best part, but it's one of the best parts.
No crocodile.
Gobi Gobi is.
Crack-a-dillo.
Gobi Gobi's good.
Crack-a-dildo?
Crack-a-dildo.
Crack-a-dildo. Whoa, wow. Is that crack-a-dildo? What?
I don't think that's covered under warranty.
Oh, look.
I've fucked it too hard. I'm sorry. Is that covered? I have the extended warranty. No, it's. Sorry.
No.
I fucking. Gruntilda got a hold of it and just it went down from there. 260. No, it's bullshit. Then how do I fucking?
You ain't going to there for a while.
It's definitely almost 2 a.m. on a banjo stream.
That's
in this conversation.
Gobi Gobi Desert.
Gobi Gobi.
I'm trying to think. There was the 180 door that we came.
There's a wonder you didn't go in because you need the muscle piece and you didn't want to go there.
No, we went there. That was a treasure show. Okay.
Yeah, like we went to.
We do have to go to. Fuck this part. No, we have to go here. It's this and then Gobi Gobi. She went to town on it. Alright, we have to do this
absolutely.
Bullshit.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
This is Clanker's Cavern. This isn't the worst one.
Clankety clank clank.
I forget, what's the name of the thing with the giant ship? Gobi Gobi Desert is a desert. It's not the ship level.
Is it? There's a ship in the desert.
This is Clanker's Cavern.
Yeah, it's Clanker's. I thought you actually was the biggest name of the giant.
Yeah, what's the one with like the bay? It has the ship and it's all poison and stuff. It's terrible.
Gobi, Gobi.
Gobi Gobi Desert, Mark.
Yeah.
Yeah, Gobi Gobi.
Gobi Gobi.
It sounds right.
No, Gobi Gobi Desert is the name of the giant fucking.
Gobi Gobi Bay.
Gobi Gobi. That's no. You're thinking of Super Mario Sunshine. Grunty wears massive bloomers under that repulsive dress of hers.
Why are you looking?
You gotta come rip a big ass somehow.
Yeah, right. True, she's also got this nasty pet dog whose name is Ripper. Hey man, doggo probably pretty nice.
Chip the Ripper.
Chip the Ripper. My sister sings in her own band, Grunty and the Monster Mob. They're awful. Maybe it's just not your taste of music.
You know? Right. A lot of these.
Fucking bitch.
Right.
Fuck you.
You fucking bitch.
Yeah, what is her
problem? Alright, let's see if I can make this right. Here we go. Yes!
Alright, just like a nice dookie blump.
What? A dookie blump? What are you, Otto's words? What the hell? Alright, here we go to Baker's Cavern to do some dental work.
Hey, get on. Get a dookie blump.
A dookie Alright.
Yes.
Bubble Goop Swamp. This is how we get into
and
Bubble Goop.
I thought Gruntilda was gross.
Stop it. If I hear gloop one more time, if I hear an onomatopoeia uttered, it sounds like...
Bubble Goop Swamp is the next level. Let's go!
Rusty Bucket Bay.
No, Rusty Bucket Bay, yes. Rusty Bucket Bay is the one with the ship. There's Clanker's Cavern, which is a water level that has a giant, shark thing that's made of... Yeah, Clanker. And then there's a fucking... There's Rusty Bucket Bay, which is just a bay that has a giant ship, and there's a jiggy piece you have to get that's in between two of these spinning fans, and you die, yes. And it sets you all the way back, and when you die, you lose all your notes. So that's a thing.
No.
You keep your note high score, but you have to go recollect them.
Well, luckily we're not gonna have to see that in 15 minutes.
No, we're just gonna get into a little bit of this bubble gloop swamp. Some bubble.
Look, I was saying the same thing.
Some bubble hump
shrimp cake, bubble hump shrimp pie.
Well, while we're on our way, guys. What's how y'all feeling? We're doing good.
Gobi.
Yeah, well, I agree. Fully agree, 100%.
Yeah,
everything Marcus has said up to this point. Just disregard Gobi.
I mean, really, honestly, I mean, when you think about it, ultimately, at the end of the day, despite everything that's happened, I mean, Gobi is essentially going to be the biggest Gobi that's
night.
Gobi in my life, but Gobi.
Right.
Tonight is the
I
night.
I love Gobi. You Gobi.
Gobi is the key to life.
Tonight's the night where Hotline Bling won Best Hip Hop Song of 2016, so Gobi indeed.
Exactly.
Gobi. But I'm glad that Triforce remembered Rusty Bucket Bay, because it is not fun. All right,
Rusty
Bucket
Bay, more like. Whoa.
All right, you're going to like this one, Dave, quite a bit. This is one of my favorite levels just because it's so fucking cute.
Bubblegum Swamp.
Bubblegum Swamp.
What was that under the...
Oh, those are invincibility feathers. We'll learn that soon. Keep your eyes open for new moves.
No, shit, that move is sick.
Have you guys seen that video? Was that the one online where he's like, your moves are weak, Mom.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, yes. That fucking
I'm not fam. Yeah, you shared that shit.
Yes,
I'd seen that a while ago, but you shared that? Oh my god. Fucking, yeah, bitch.
Fucking bitch, don't call your mama bitch.
I'm not your fucking dad.
What?
What are you saying? Why am I not fam anymore? Because your moves are weak. Your moves are weak.
Yeah, your moves are weak.
What about the moves? There were no moves. These are the wading boots. Chicken Leg wears them so you can safely wade through dangerous areas like the swamp for a limited time. Thank you. That is exactly it. I wanted all of that. Keep shooting. Huh? Yeah. Fuck you! Murdered some frogs. Alright, don't talk to your mom like that. Alright, these guys, they just need an egg shot in their face. Alright, there's about five of those. This is Croctus.
Actually, that's a croc.
Yeah, you hit one and then the next one shows up. The reason I like this level so much is because it's so fucking fun! That's all. Like, literally, it's just got a bunch of really cool things, whereas Treasure Trove Cove is a lot of exploration. This one's got a lot of cool... Oh, no!
Yeah, right?
It's got a lot of its good own ideas.
I think it is.
Grab some of those.
Light her up!
Not gonna do that yet.
Silver Snow!
Wow, did I not get any of those? Alright, let's try again. The thing is, the wading boots, you do not have, like, shit for time, so it's not even worth it half the time. Yeah, this is fun. You take, like, 2 damage. Ooh, or 1 if you're good. Yeah, I'm just gonna clean this up. We'll go do the wading boot stuff. This part's fast. We're gonna do the fast stuff. Murder him.
That was
we'll get invincibility.
That was a super poisonous frog, by the way. In real life, if you ever seen one of those things, you'd be dead.
Yeah.
The real small, colorful.
Yeah, the small, colorful ones, like the dark frogs.
Dark frog, yep.
Yeah.
All right, so this part's
dead.
Super fun.
Touch it, dead.
I need serious time. Nope. Serious time.
Serious time.
It's actually not. They don't need serious time. I think it's on a timer. It's just like you have to run these things.
I've been serious this whole stream. I don't know about you.
I got 45 seconds to get up there, guys. How am I going to do it?
I'm not fucking
How
around.
Am I going to do it? Serious. Not even changing the camera. Oh my god!
Fail.
That's what happens when you talk shit.
Well, that's fine.
Serious time. Remember, put your serious boots on.
I'm there. Don't worry.
I got eggs.
Oh, come on. That didn't pop.
Eggs Benedict.
Eggs Benedict.
Come on, let's go.
Eggs Benedict Cumbersnatch.
Benadryl Cumbersnatch?
But it's can't all Benadryl right, Cumbersnatch, yeah.
Cumberswobble. What is that, a bee? You're adopted, yeah. Wait, so I'm adopted.
Dark frogs!
Dark frogs.
Wait,
no,
those are dark frogs. Yeah, those things will kill you. I heard that some of those were seen, like, locally recently. Yeah. That, like.
Who the fuck brought those in?
I don't know, dude. That's the only time you'd ever say that.
Ever.
Danald.
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 Come on.
Don't call her mom.
It's not your fucking mom. What are you doing? Me and my wife are leaving. Mom, what are you. I'm not your fucking mom, not your dad. What were the moves? There were no moves. There were no moves.
So far, Dave, on a scale of 1 to scaling, what do you give this game?
I mean, I haven't really seen, like, I played a nice deal of scaler, and I didn't play, I mean, I was just on, like the third world, I think.
Yeah, there's, the worlds are very
My favorite world is the snow one.
Yeah, dude. Oh my god, with the giant
it's
Christmas
so
tree.
It's so cool and so creative.
Yeah. Scaler had a little bit more combat involved.
Okay, so it was more like, scaler was more like Knack.
Well, this is the level where it starts to get into combat.
Scaler was more like a more platformy heavy cameo.
Ah.
So
yeah, cameo's like a lot.
Yeah, like cameo was like platformy was more based on combat versus.
Your controller matters though, perfect timing.
Scaler, but I don't want to compare those again. I compare this more to maybe like a croc.
Yeah, I mean it's like that.
Yeah.
I mean, you better watch your mouth. That really upset Shiro last time. You triggered him.
I'm sorry, I mean, that reminds me of croc. That's not a bad thing. I enjoy croc.
He enjoyed that.
I just think Banjo-Kazooie's age. I think
like
Banjo.
Looks, he was like,
Banjo
he didn't even look at him. He just looked straight at him. He's like, yeah, you better.
Probably. I mean, I haven't played Croc in a long time. Croc's levels are probably a lot more linear than this.
Let's
fucking Russian Dow eggs, man. What the fuck?
Dude, yeah. We should.
Not bring in the Ryu. Ooh.
Gah-huh.
What's Ryu?
You gonna go and grab that Ryu?
Ryu? You can?
Was
Street Fighter
everyone's?
Y'all
go. No, I don't believe so.
I guess we got the Ryu.
Eat him, fuck him!
Eat him, nice. Fuck him.
Alright, let's try to get this, let's try to get this
fuck
one.
Come on. This time, guys, serious.
Oh, we don't really need to be serious.
Sheeny Sparky, Sheeny Sparky, Sheeny Sparky.
Shiny, shiny. I actually gotta stop and do this.
Spiky, spiky.
Oh fuck, I hope this is not gonna happen.
Yes.
Oh,
come over here. Yes, sir. Give me some. Yes, yes. I hope you miss. Yes, yes.
You guys know what to follow up with so many times.
Yeah.
Bring me like, a red squirrel.
Yep.
Well, yeah, because I can go back and do this stuff slower, so I can make sure I actually grab it.
I am the great mighty Pooh, and I'm going to throw my shit at you.
That was a few days ago. Yeah, that shit was real good. We'll be continuing that on. All right, let's move over to
Yeah, we're gonna go become a little crocodile. That's gonna be the cute part. I like this part a lot.
Oh, now it really is gonna become croc.
Yeah, now it's gonna actually become croc. This way. Yeah, I'm gonna do the crocodile. Because I feel like I like the crocodile.
Dilla.
This one
doesn't have a penis, so it's Dilla.
There you go.
This is the song that was like forever in my head. Yep.
Oh yeah, the music is the best.
Good old Grant Kirkhope.
Come on, come on, come on.
Nice.
Yes.
This should be made into a great band because of his
style. Oh, that'd be sick. Oh, yeah.
And the grandma. I listen to all kind of music. Country.
Rockafilla.
Crocafilla.
Crocafilla.
Right, Jinjo.
Yeah, Crocafilla in the house.
Alright. This is one of my favorite parts.
Crocafilla. I feel like that's how you sound. I don't know why. I feel like that's how you would. Crocafilla.
Throw the keys to you.
Yeah.
And you left from Central.
Fuck.
You're stupid.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to make
nice catch. Off the wall.
Nope.
Off the wall. That was amazing.
Oh god. All right. We gotta do this the normal way. Otherwise, I'm gonna die. All right. We're good.
Dang. That was nice.
Yeah. That was almost like a that fucking
nice
level ender. All right. We need to get the Mumbo. Oh my god, Mumbo. This is what happens when I ignore all those honeycombs.
Very stressful. Yeah. I love that song. It's, but you know what? It's sad because I always, when you sing it, it just reminds me, it's Olive Garden commercial. And that's the only time I heard it. Olive Garden. It's Olive Garden
yeah,
commercial.
Yeah, they use it in a commercial.
Yeah, so whenever I hear that song, I'm just like, all right, Olive Garden. It's fucked up.
Hold on. Let's get there.
Hey, this is great. This is like, it's like real time. It's like that movie Inside Out. It's like the memories are in our brain right now, just like feeding us random songs. It's like 2 a.m. on
Sunday
night, basically Monday, yeah. Monday morning. Like, I had Smash Mouth in my head for a week. It was terrible. Yeah, dude. It really was. I'm not kidding.
Nope.
Yeah, every time I'd do that. It would start, and I'd be like, no.
No.
Like some.
Yep, I'll be like, you shut the fuck.
Some shit.
It was exactly like that. I got every time you get to the sum, it was like,
oh shit.
Yeah. Oh no.
Oh.
Oh, that's dope. What is this?
It's real.
Wait a minute. How is... Wait.
Triforce made
Rio Perler.
Triforce made this? This is yeah. Sweet. How do you make this?
Sweet Perler.
Oh, Perlers. Oh, that's dope. Yeah.
You grab yourself some beads. Make
oh,
your,
hell yeah.
Make your, find yourself one of them.
Dude, this is sick.
I was telling you, Triforce can sell all the time.
Yeah, I got a buddy. I got a buddy who used to do that. Chris Sayers.
Hey,
Chris Sayers.
Triforce, make the space brain move.
Mr. Jolly.
Oh, dude, yeah, I can commission you for that. We actually have a 3D printed version of the Space Brain logo, and we just don't have a way of coloring it.
Space Brain.
But yeah, the Space Brain logo, like this would be dope.
Space paint. There you go.
So, did you make this for Space Brain? Is this like a gift?
That
or
is
just...
Mario.
Oh.
It is this... not for you.
That's okay, though. Because now I'm...
He heard Mario was coming over.
Oh, so this is for Mario. Nice. Okay, so we can surprise him on stream. That's awesome. So Dave, make sure you keep this safe, and then surprise him. Surprise him on. Well, yeah, he's not gonna be watching the stream. But if you are watching the stream, happy birthday.
Yeah, happy.
Happy Hadouken birthday.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, I know. He never. Richard Trappers never ever given to him.
So sweet.
Bring me some sweet corn.
I don't know where I want to put this, but we can hold it for now.
Space Spin logo would be huge. Well, make it smaller. You can probably shrink that down. It's a good
day. Yeah. You check out the cake in there?
Oh, no, I have not. Otherwise, I want to eat it.
Yeah, that's a good point. Right, you should wait.
I have seen the pit. Well, I'm not gonna be able to eat that cake because I'm doing Valentine's Day things.
Mm-hmm.
My woman, so I will not be here for Valentine's.
We'll have leftover.
All right, let's go become the cutest motherfucker in the world.
Look at him, he's so cute with a little backpack.
No, look at him, look.
Woo!
No, he is. He's fucked up. He'll fucking murder you and your family. Listen to him. Listen to his fucking intensity in his voice. Oh, that's someone who'll murder your entire family.
It's the cute ones that are dangerous.
Dead before you even know it.
It is like Croc now.
Yeah, no, that was the joke, because now he's literally a Croc. We're going to see if we can grab this like we can't, because trash.
Croc makes literally the same thing. Yep, it's Croc. It's building its way up.
So now, we're going to go do this awesome thing. This is my favorite part of this level, and one of the last things we have to do. No, they're not interested in him.
Looks like it's slow.
Triforce says, oh, he's giving his time to a lady. I see, we're not good enough.
Man, no.
When he comes to ladies, hell no.
Yeah,
Gotta get that.
Everybody,
gotta get the vajayjay for V-Day, baby.
Oh, that is so weird. I love this part, though.
All right. Ready for this action, dude?
I do love this part.
Wait, do you unlock the boots doing that?
I think so.
Her! I'm Mr. Vile, greediest croc of all. Play my game to win a prize. Press A to accept to beat a chicken out. So his game is pretty much you grab the red yumblies and avoid the yellow yumblies. It's essentially just like whack-a-mole. Oh, I keep forgetting that you have to press X to... And it gets way harder. Essentially the idea is to block him out so he doesn't get to eat the one thing. Yeah, you essentially... Oh shit, I think you... Nope.
Oh shit.
Come on, don't do me like this.
No.
I gotta get this one over here.
Oh, he's high. No.
He's gonna probably get this one too. Nope.
Oh man. This is fucking... Oh god! Oh! You dirty!
No.
Oh, he got it though. Oh.
Come on!
Trolls!
Because the axe actually propels you, it's a new bit. Fuck! Good time.
Yeah.
Ty still counts as laws, though. And then he comes and he tries to.
Oh, yeah, you cheat by getting the shoes.
God damn, you move fast.
Yes, he will. He will attack.
Damn.
I'm gonna eat you
down. How dare you lose!
Where's the little singy part? Or that's another one. I'll try to do that again. Yeah, I was trying to remember how you get the fucking shoes. You don't need them, but it's way easier with them. Oh, let's go again, boy. Yeah, this one isn't even hard. The red yellow one.
Nice! Yeah, follow.
That's normally how you do it. You just want to love your point too.
Yep.
Your brother actually taught me that.
Yeah, we have to start. I don't like being at the top because it's hard to see where everything else is spawning. Yep. Ooh, it's not over till the crocodile bites here, does it?
Oh my god!
Oh, nice steal! Oh!
Oh, dummy.
Got this. Nice.
Grr, you only win easy game, now we play harder game. Eat reds, avoid yellow, grumblies, they not ripe, ready, 3, 2, 1, go! So this one's funny, because this is essentially where you just kind of box them out. There's yellow ones that you can't eat, and they make you lose. Or they just hurt you like a bird.
Oh, damn.
Come on. Because that, the bite actually propels you a teeny bit.
Shit.
Trash.
Dang, but he's boxing you out a little bit.
Yeah, it's this one's not fun. If you have the boots, it's so much easier.
Big fun.
Hell yeah.
Come on, where's everything's coming in?
Damn, right in his path, basically?
Yeah, that's why I don't...
Nice. Oh, she almost pushed you into one. She did. Nice though.
Easy peasy lemon. Bah, lucky greenie wins. Must play last game. Only eat what is shown at top of screen. Ready, 3, 2, 1, go.
Wow, forgot to be in this man. Just red for right now.
This one's actually somewhat easier, dependent. The only way it fucks you up is if you're like legit about to eat something. There we go. That's what I mean by boxing him out.
That's nice.
Come on, go red. Ooh. Yellow, red, red. Come on, don't fuck with me. Thank you.
How you say red in Japanese?
Red.
Fuck.
Nice, by one.
God damn, that was good.
Narrow. Very narrow.
Too close. All right.
Yep.
Well, this is what I mean, like, why, like, Bubble Goop Swamp and stuff like that is because it's, there is their own ideas. It's not just running around. It's kind of like how Mario 64, you have, like, oh, you can race the penguin, and, like, that's a cool thing you do.
There's, like, different things you do in the level.
Yeah. Oh, here he is. Okay. Beep, beep, beep,
Scalerhead is, so I guess, kind of like Scaler in that way, because it wasn't just, in Scaler, you didn't just beat up everything. You, like, each level you had different things that you did with the transformation. Like one was like, oh, you race this other thing and you do other things. So, Croc, I don't know if you did all these extra things. I can't remember.
I did this out of order. I got too excited to do the crocodile thing. I forgot, because I was like looking around, I was like, where's the singy thing? That's in the turtle shell, and we need to be Banjo in the turtle shell. Luckily, we don't have to go through the whole entire maze, because this is here. We can change it back. Change it back, and now we don't have to use, we don't have to use tokens for that because we've already done it once. This is gonna be a good chance to attempt to get. Give me a good chance to try and get that other jiggy. There is no sync, so you guys are probably hating your lives right now. Just listening. Kazoo! Alright. Let's try doing this. Oh, 10 seconds, right? Motherfucker. Hit one more time. Yep. Okay, please do not stop me half jump and kill me. Fuck! Okay.
Oh man.
Yeah, I'm just gonna abandon this. Oh wait, I don't have any. Oh no. Okay, life is gonna suck for a minute here while I attempt to get more pieces of health. It's not good because if I touch any of this water, I'm dead. Yeah, I'm gonna do this part real quick, because this is easy. We're getting up there, guys. Don't worry. This is how you open the grate that's by the Brentilda, I believe. Yeah. Now you can get it top, and get the jiggy in there. No. No, hold on. Don't get jiggy right now. You wait for your jigginess.
Yeah! Sniped!
Get a little bit racist.
A little bit.
Just a little taste of that racism.
Yeah, taste of racism.
Gahaha, that was pretty racist. Gahaha, I don't think people would appreciate that, Kazooie. Just trying to get. Okay.
That's how you laugh when it gets old. Let's go, Kazooie.
Oh, I should have just smoked all those cigarettes. Oh, Kazooie put my sandwich through my feeding tube. Kazooie's dead because she's a fucking bird. Psych, birds. Birds last about like 30 years. So this is kind of fucked up, actually. Now that I think about it, this dude is just chilling. First, here, let me grab. All right, don't be rude.
Damn, I know juice went right into the water.
Oh my God, stop. Okay. Jeez, do I really have to do this? Oh my God, no. Yeah, I'm just gonna do the trot thing. I was just trying to make the jump. Okay. I just wanted to go get the Jinjo and then the fucking life. Waiting for it to go. Yes. All right, so this is fucked up, Banjo-Kazooie. Is this part's very unassuming? There's just this nice, like, look at this turtle, dude. He's just like a nice turtle.
He's chilling.
And he's like, "Hurrow!" And then you're just like, "Hey, fuck you!" He's like, "Oh, that's a bit better." Because his legs hurt because they're outside. He can't tuck himself back into his shell. I was just kidding. You don't actually fuck him up for no reason. That'd be kind of messed up.
I was a little hurt. I was like,
"Yeah, he doesn't really like it." Yeah, he screams. Tank top to warm it less, perhaps you like the shit. Alright, so you grab this. Got it. Too easy. I believe you do that as a croc. Oh, no, you don't have to do it as a crocodile. Alright, this is the part. No, yeah, this is the part I was talking about. Dave, you like this. Let me grab the notes first. This part can either be not terrible or super terrible. We're close. Alright, let's go. Quiet, please. The famous Tip Top Choir will now perform my latest work. Is it copy what you just heard for lesson one? Oh, I already forgot. Oh my God, what is it? It's him, and then him.
No.
Okay. All right. Red, yellow, purple. Not too bad. Try lesson two. Red. Purple. Yellow.
Red, purple, yellow, pink, yellow. Red. Purple.
Yellow, pink, yellow. Alright, this is gonna be a team effort. I remember three, Shear remembers three, Mark remembers three. Ready? You just remember three. Three of the colors. So I'm gonna remember yellow, purple, red. Shear, remember this.
Blue, red, light blue.
And then Marcus, remember this. Oh, it's just red. Okay.
I got mine, guys!
I forgot mine. What was it? Red, purple, yeah, red. No! Alright, whatever. My bad. Oh. Shit. God damn it. Well, here we have it. Yellow, purple, red, blue, light blue. Yellow, purple, red, blue, red, light blue, red.
Red.
Jesus Christ. What was it then?
Yellow,
yellow. Purple. Red. Blue.
All right.
Yellow. This is the best part.
Oh, what?
Red. Then pick her.
Well,
all right. Are you sure?
I know it ends in red.
Oh, okay, then it's red. Magnificent, a true masterpiece. Here, yeah, take this trinket I found earlier.
Gah-huh?
I am disappointed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dave, I think you like this part.
I mean, it's the music part, so I was like, Dave might like this part, because it's the music class.
It was interesting music.
I like the little music. They're friends. They're
why are you doing music inside of his goddamn stomach?
They're turtles inside of another turtle. Let's sing little songs.
Is that a woman turtle? Was it pregnant?
Dave's criticizing.
Dave's like, fuck this. They're not even good. They're not even a good quality.
I've seen much better turtles perform live. In concert.
TBH.
Yeah.
Tortoises are better.
Yeah. Very underrated though.
Yeah. That, yeah, on that note I think that's pretty much a wrap on this. We'll get back to some more banjo.
We are almost done with this world, so we will wrap up this world while Cal takes his leave. Everyone's gonna leave me as we finish Bubble Gloop Swamp. That's fine. I only got about 9 more notes to collect and 3 more jiggies, but I know which ones those are. So no big deal. And then when we come back for part 2, whenever that is, it will be Clanker's Cavern and Gobi Gobi Desert.
Gobi Gobi!
Alright, guys, it was fun to be with you. Marcus needs some sleep.
Lick on my butt. Hold, lick my butt. That's the sign off.
Cut it out.
I think you just dropped some.
I didn't need it. It's broke.
By my right foot.
Gooby. Gooby. Gooby Desert.
Gooby Gooby.
Gooby Gooby Desert.
Gooby Gooby. So, what are you going to be doing in the desert?
Gooby Gooby. Gooby Gooby.
Come on, come on.
I come out of nowhere. Gooby Gooby.
All right, we're going to try this one more time. We need to get this in order to...
I will have a save Gooby Gooby. You guys have a save Gooby Gooby.
Are you fucking kidding me? No!
Oh no! The Gobi Gobi's got him!
No! No! Motherfuck!
Oh god!
Uh-oh.
Oh! Gobi Gobi Island!
Gobi Gobi!
I love that
shit.
Gala Gala.
Wait, so when you die, you lose all your notes?
Yeah, no.
Oh no, I must have been tripping. I'm good. Never mind, it's not that big of a deal. We don't lose the notes. No, if you leave the world and come back, that's what it is. Okay, we're good. Alright, then never mind, I'm not that stressed.
Alright, guys. Oh, jeez. Adios.
Avita Zane. Avita Zane.
Avita Zane.
Gobi Gobi. Gobi Gobi. Arigato. Alright, this is gonna be the one that just messes me up the entire time. Because all we need to do is get that. The version saves your notes. Okay, so I'm not tripping. Then in the N64 version, you do lose your notes? Because I played the Xbox version once, 100%, and that was it. You know, so I played mainly N64. So maybe that overreaction was not for nothing. Yeah, which is why I usually grab, because you don't have to get 100 notes. You just have to get as many notes as you need for the next door. This part is always just messed me up. I don't know why. It's like not a terrible thing, and you saw me. I do other things quickly. It's just this, because it's like nothing but death below. I'm just gonna take it slow. Because from here I can just jump. All right, cool. Well, we do have to redo Dave. The small thing we have to redo is the crocodiles that I was shooting eggs in their mouth. Because those have reset. So we'll go do those real quick. That's fine. Yeah, you remember the little gold crocodiles?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so those have reset, I believe. Or I'm tripping and they're not reset. Let's see. Nope, they're reset. Okay. number one right here. Here's the blue guy.
Me want yummy egg too.
The stream got quiet, man. It was like the beginning, fucking quick fire. Everyone's screaming. It's exciting. A little bit off that Gears of War fondness. We'll get to relax at the end of Bubble Gloop Swamp. It's all quiet. Dave is an appreciator. He likes to watch the game and take it all in.
Yeah. I've never really seen this. This might be the greatest game I've ever seen in my life.
And honestly, most of the later levels are the better parts. I mean, Sans, like I was talking about with the few of them that are kind of disappointing and not entirely fun, a lot of these levels, it's truly the environments and the music that accompanies them that makes them as good. Did I also lose my Jinjos? I don't think so. No, I didn't. Okay. See, that's something I know you lose. Your little Jinjo guys you collect. But I still have them. Yeah, so that's good. I don't have to pick them up again. Okay, so I'm not gonna become a crocodile yet. I gotta get up here to get the other, one. Yeah, Banjo-Kazooie started off as something very, very different. It was an isometric adventure game, but after they moved it from Super Nintendo to development on N64, they decided to go more in the line of Super Mario 64 because of how well that was doing. But before, Banjo-Kazooie was called a game called Dream Something. I can't remember TDH. But you didn't play as a bear, you played as a dude. She played as a guy, I believe, and they said, like, hey, we need to change it up. So they eventually changed it into an amorphic bear.
Animal mascots were all very effective.
Yeah, and then they wanted him, they had the idea of, for a certain move, that, like, legs would sprout out the back of his backpack that he had. And then eventually that just led to Kazooie existing as a person, or as a character. Okay, so we got that one. The last one we need is actually where we're going to become a croc. Am I stuck on that? Okay.
Did you do that one already?
Which?
The croc one.
Oh, yeah, so everything's already done. I have to become a crocodile to, I guess technically I don't have to, but it's easier because when you're a crocodile, you can go in the water without getting hurt. And the final notes that I need are in some Watchtower. So we're gonna go become a crocodile one last time. Dave, how do you prefer it? See, like with Banjo, when you go into a world, all of the jiggies are accessible to you at any given point. Versus a game like Mario 64, where each world, or each level, or star, I could say, is a different instance of that level. In fact, sometimes different stars change the level entirely. What do you actually like? Do you like a level that changes due to the objective, or a level that contains all the objectives but is static?
Here, you know what, Dave? Why don't you take that?
Oh yeah, good idea.
And then I'll just grab this. There we go. We'll do a little bit of this.
There you go.
And I'll make this come out here so you can hear me. Dave can talk. We can both talk. Everything's good. All right, there we go. Here we go. Become a crocodile.
A crocodile.
A crocodilia.
I'm not sure which one I really like more. I actually do like the idea of like the world changing based on the star in Mario 64. I think Mario Galaxy did it too.
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah.
But at the same time, it in a way, I can see how that can kind of just, like, pad the game because you have to run through the level again.
Dave, real quick, this is what Cal was referring to.
Wait.
Sometimes it's random it happens. You turn into a dishwasher. sometimes just by accident. Mumbo accidentally turns you into a dishwasher. Sometimes a toilet, even. I believe, actually, that's the second game. But yeah, that's what he was talking about. You play as a dishwasher.
Can you actually play as that?
I don't remember, actually. The first time it happens, I know, like, well, as we just saw, it immediately throws you back to being a crocodile. But I don't know. I know you can play as the toilet at some point.
That's funny.
Yeah, I think that's in the second one.
I'm pretty sure we can survive in this swamp as a washing machine.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing that's gonna hurt you. You're literally a washing machine.
Yeah, but also, you probably can't move either.
True. True. Ah, shit, I forgot to shoot that with the... It's okay. We're gonna go grab the extra little things we need. The only thing about the crocodile is that he moves very slow.
Yep.
In comparison. But he's so cute.
Yeah, I think the having the game, like, change the level a little bit, it's kind of like game padding, and in some cases it works, and in some cases it could be cool, in some cases it can just be annoying.
Yeah, like, I think the biggest, or the easiest thing to point out is in the very beginning of Mario 64, you know, the first star is the race, and that is, it's got the rolling balls, it's got all that stuff, but the next time, the game, the entire level doesn't change, but enemy placement has been changed, stuff like that, so it's almost like they have tuned the, oh, I guess I didn't need to become a crocodile, because there's boots right there. They've tuned the level to the objective, I guess, which is kind of interesting.
Right, so you see it as different, so as soon as you get into the level, it's like, oh, I gotta go play the level again, yeah. But then you immediately see, oh, things are different right now. So
one thing, go ahead, sorry.
Oh, no, that was just gonna say, so it's a little bit more interesting.
The one thing that I do like about Banjo is you don't get kicked out every single time. Because, you know, in Mario 64, you get a star, you get kicked back out of the painting, you go back in, you do something different. Banjo, you get... I feel like you get more familiar with the level purely because you're constantly in it and you can leave at any time. But, yeah, I like that it doesn't kick you out after each objective. You know, you can do a whole 10 jiggy run and just play the level. Whereas Mario, you know, you're getting kicked out every few stars.
You know, it's interesting you kind of say that because in Color Splash, the game I'm playing now, they do the same thing except the level doesn't change. So there might be, like, 3 paint stars in one level.
Ah.
And the thing is, once you get a paint star, you get, like, put back on the world map. But the level doesn't change per paint star. It's just, you know, you got...
It kicks you out?
You got the paint star, you're out, you're done.
That's kind of silly.
So it's like, so you get the paint star. Up, you're turning back.
Turning back to band.
I'm hoping for a washing machine again.
Yeah, it only happens, I think, maybe once every, like, 1 out of 6 times, I would say. It's like a probability. Because it happens, it just happens in a crazy amount.
That's random.
Yeah.
That's cool, though. But yeah, like, in Paper Mario, you get kicked out of level after you get the star, and then you're like, okay, well, now I gotta go back in, and I gotta go through the parts that I've been through already. In most cases, the levels aren't super complicated, so you can kind of just walk back to where you were, but it's still kind of like, oh, and I gotta come back.
Yeah, you gotta retrace everything. It's kind of a little bit obnoxious. Yep. There's one of my favorite level, like I said, Click Clock Woods. It's not my favorite level purely just because of the music, but... It kind of bridges the gap. The reason I asked that question is to bring this up. It bridges the gap in the fact that it is both a level that contains all the objectives, but has to be changed to get them. So Click Clock Woods is actually 4 levels in one. It's a big tree, right?
Yep.
And the 4 different levels are seasons. So you go there in the winter, like, for example, there's one jiggy where you have to swim into this little dam made by built by a beaver, right?
Yep.
If you go in the winter, you can't get down there because it's all frozen over. You go in the fall, you know, like, things are... It's crazy because, like, 4 different levels, but the same hub. So once you understand everything, oh, it's really cool. It's really cool. It's probably one of my favorite...
That is really cool.
N64, 3, like, Mario, Banjo, regardless, it's one of my favorite things because, it's really cool. And the graphics reflect it, and the music reflects it. It's a very, very, very cool level. Unfortunately, like the last level you do.
There's another game that did something like that where I thought it was really neat because it changes based on like the time or the season or something. I can't remember what it was, but it was really neat.
Triforce, if you're still in here, where the fuck is the last jigsaw piece? Oh, it's Jinjo's. That's why. I'm dumb. Never mind.
So you gotta do the thing in turtle again?
I just have to go grab this Jinjo over here. This little, guy. I forgot to grab him. This should be it. I'm gonna grab the boots real quick so I don't get hurt. Yeah. Thanks, Triforce! Are you kidding me? Okay. Okay, I guess I can't do this with the boots. I'll just take it heart of damage, whatever.
You can't pick it up?
No, you have to be, like, underneath this little lip.
Oh.
I guess they want you to do it with the crocodile, but, like, you don't need to. I actually might be able to do it without getting hurt. Wait, what? You really want me to become the crocodile? God damn, dude. That's kind of silly.
Yeah,
whatever. It's the last thing, and then we can just exit the level. We're good.
You got all the notes?
Yes, we got all the notes. Actually, you do need to exit the level as a crocodile. Anyways, well, it's easier to do it with a crocodile, because there's a path that has, like, swamp water in the overworld. But yeah, let's go become a crocodile for, like, the 8th time. Maybe we'll get a washing machine if we're lucky.
Ooh.
I did this all fucking out of whack.
I think one of the things that kind of reminded me of, Croc with this was, like, the character design of all of the inanimate objects that have eyes on them.
Yeah, yeah, it's very, very much a rare thing. You know, you look at Mario 64, not all of the fucking objects are characters. That's very much something you saw in Croc, you saw in Banjo, and in Clonker. But no, I mean, unless they were animals, you didn't really
characters like, those big eyes on them.
Very cartoony.
Yeah, that's what I said on the last stream. Clonker was like the grown-up version of Pajama Sam.
Yeah. Where in Pajama Sam, like, doors are characters, you know, like, fucking mine carts are characters.
Yep.
We'll have to do Pajama Sam.
Oh, Pajama Sam was great. I actually bought, Thunder and Lightning Aren't So Frightening on Steam, actually.
See, I don't know, how much do they run on Steam? Are they, like, $5, $10? Because I have, like, all of them, I just never do.
I think they're, like, $10.
Jeez.
I think...
They did re-release them. I mean, there was a Pajama Sam No Need to Hide When It's Dark Outside for the Wii.
Yeah, for the Wii, yeah. Apparently, HE still makes kids games of, like, on Apple and all that stuff.
Oh, I'm sure. I think Freddy Fish is on the App Store now.
Really?
Huh. Yeah, I mean, Humongous Entertainment has been doing stuff to try and push those. Because the thing about Pajama Sam and Freddy Fish, which these are children's point-and-click adventure games, if you're unaware, they truly are kind of timeless. They don't have any cultural references in them.
Yeah.
And they're kind of like Disney flicks. Like, yeah, Freddy Fish is still going to be good in the year 2017 because it's just a story about a girl fish and her little friend boy fish, and they're trying to find some treasure.
Some stuff. Yep.
Yeah, and Pajama Sam is just this little boy in pajamas who's trying to conquer his fears. It's very centralized theming, you know, things that resonate with kids regardless of how old you are, what year you grow up in. You're still going to be afraid of the dark.
Plus, it was there are some, like, legitimately funny parts.
Oh, yeah, the game's fucking hilarious. Especially, You Are What You Eat From Your Head to Your Feet.
Oh, that man, one is super yeah, funny. That one is really funny.
Okay, we have completed Bubble Goop Swamp.
Nice.
So with that, we'll wrap up for the night, guys. We're going to get back. I'm going to go and hit the puzzle that is outside of this level. So we're going to return to the overworld real quick. We're getting there. Yeah, so, guys, do not forget, if you want, you can support the stream. There is a support button where you can donate money to us that goes towards production costs and things you want to play. If you guys have, like, extra games or something and you know us, you can send them to us. We'll have a P.O. box within a decent amount of time so you guys can send us games. If you don't have any of that kind of stuff, don't be afraid to share. I got a message from Finesse3D. I should have turned off notifications. It's my friend John. So we're going to see exactly how much John is going to blow us up. Hopefully not a lot. I guess we're ending the stream here. We'll find out. So yeah, usually you need to grab boots and then they might run out about halfway through.
Oh, but you can get through here
with the crocodile. You don't turn back in. This is the, I like that the overworld theme changes tonally based upon
where
the
you
environment.
Are. You know, actually,
Freezy Peak is what we're unlocking.
The,
Crash Team Racing actually did the same thing.
I didn't play a lot of Crash Team Racing.
You did or you did not?
No, I did not.
Oh.
I played a lot of Crash, but not a lot of Crash Team Racing.
Yeah, Crash Team Racing, it was a big contender for Mario Kart and Mario Kart. I'm getting tired. And in my personal opinion, maybe it's because I'm just a PlayStation kid. I actually kind of thought it was a little bit better.
Than what, Mario Kart?
Than Crash Team Racing, I thought it was a bit better than Mario Kart.
I never played Mario Kart 64 a lot when I was a kid.
Oh.
Just something I didn't do.
Oh, okay. Yeah, like Mario Kart 64, I mean, it was pretty...
I got into Mario Kart around Double Dash.
Oh, yeah.
Or whatever the GameCube one was.
I think that might have been Devil Man.
Triforce said, yeah, CTR did it too. It's just such a nice thing because it's just a melody. And all you need to do is just change the synth and like this is very thumpy and very dirty.
Yep. Yeah. And then like you go to the winter one, it's like and very little bells and stuff.
Soothing and bells.
Yeah,
and
that
stuff
is
like
that is really neat.
I think the saves whenever I quit.
Does it auto save?
Yeah. Well, it saves when you quit. I'm just. Well, that was weird.
What just happened?
Yeah, the character phased through me while I was transforming. CTR was way better than Mario 64, says Triforce. Yeah, like I said, I didn't get
Mario
into I didn't get into Mario Kart 64. I was really a Double Dash kind of guy. I wasn't really a Mario Kart dude in the first place.
Oh, yeah.
I wasn't a big fan of racing games.
Yeah, Crash Team Racing had more substance to it. Because of like the whole like overworld map, and it had things you could do in that, and then it had like all the battle stuff. And then Crash Nitro Kart, which a shame, I thought I had it, but I guess it's still at my mom's house. That was like the spiritual successor, because it had an overworld map just like Crash Team Racing did. And Crash actually had an answer to Double Dash as well, which was Crash Tag Team. And if that had, I don't know if that was really a contender with that. They had a world map, sort of, but it was like a thing where you played on foot, and it was like a platformer, and it had mini games, and it was interesting. Whether it was better, that's up to opinion.
So this part right now that we're doing, just we're opening up for the future.
Oh, is this where Gobi?
This is Gobi Gobi.
Oh, Gobi Gobi. I see like sand things and
yes, it is a desert.
And
we're gonna jump in here really quick.
What is that?
It's a boss we just jumped into, which for no, it doesn't make any sense how that would work. But yeah, that's how we get that world jiggy. I just want to do that real quick, and then I'm gonna go ahead and open up Gobi Gobi. Never played the second Crash Racing game, aka it wasn't good at all, says Triforce.
He said he never played it.
He said, and I quote, never played the second Crash Racing game, aka it wasn't good at all.
Well, aka then you should probably go play it.
What are you referring to, Nitro Kart or Team Racing?
Or Tag Team. Crash Tag Team. Crash Tag Team has some neat things, but you could screw people over really easy. Because the idea was that you could. You were driving separately, but you could fuse cars with anyone.
Oh, really?
And, like, just mid-race. And so one person would be driving when the other person would be shooting the other racers. But then you could unfuse yourself at any time, too. Mid-air, right next to the finish line. So, you see how that could go bad.
No, I see. So let's unlock Gobi Gobi Desert here, and let's call it a night. I want to be...
Have levels ready for next time.
Yeah. Ooh. Actually, I don't think we can unlock.
Wait, what?
This is in the area. Freezy Peak is over there.
Do you ever level up to get more, like, honeycomb?
Yeah, so as you find them, you fill up a ring of, like, six. They're kind of like heart pieces in Zelda. Like, you get three or four of them, and then you get... In this one, you get five or six, and then you get a new piece. I just haven't been grabbing them because I'm bad. I think there's one up here, actually. Oh, it's a red symbol. Trevor says, the third one was bad was what I meant, aka the bad one thing. Let me get my brain straight. So he's referring to Tag Team Racing was the bad.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Nitro Kart.
Yeah, Nitro Kart. What was it saying?
She says, spider pancakes for breakfast. Yeah. Then she has dog bung burgers, or dung burgers for lunch.
Ew.
Wart bags and finishes with rat sorbet for dessert. So we know pretty much everything there is to know about her until now.
Yeah, she's not a really...
not a nice person. Can't go in there.
Everybody was Nintendo wants to hype up Mario Kart 8 like it was the first game to like drive on like curvy walls and things.
Yeah.
But actually a bunch of games did it.
There was quite a few games.
Yeah, like I was gonna say Crash Nitro Kart did it. I mean we played Hot Wheels World Race. Clearly that did it. So
this is Freezy Peak, which we're going to be doing on part two. But first, I'm just going to grab the overworld jiggy, and then we're going to end the stream.
I had to get to that. Oh, there you go.
Yeah, so it's kind of like a little maze here.
Ooh, I like that little star up there. It's like Christmas.
Yeah, it's a picture of a banjo and kazooie.
Wait, why is there a picture just randomly here?
I have no clue, to be honest.
There's like the thing in like old video games. It's like in Ape Escape in the time station. There's a picture of Spike's face like on the floor.
It's like, look at him.
I was like, why is his face? Why is
maybe there isn't a Jiggy up here. Maybe I'm just imagining it. Yeah, those are the shoes. Ah, that's what it is. Oh, never mind. We can't do that. Because we need to learn how to use the shoes in order to get there in time, and I don't have them unlocked. So, guys.
What?
We will be visiting Freezy Peak. Ooh. On part two. So, with that, I will, I got no issue. With that, we bid adieu. It's been fun. It's been real.
It's been really fun.
I'm glad that Dave liked a little bit of what he saw.
Yep.
And you know what, guys? We will see you later. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you Tuesday for Valentine's Day. We'll be doing some fun games then. Dave will be headlining that pretty much.
Yep.
And then we'll see you next weekend for some more Conker, maybe some more Banjo, maybe a little bit of stuff from Dave as well. We will see.
Possibly.
Stay tuned. Follow us on Twitter. You're on Twitch, YouTube, whatever you're on. Facebook, check us out there.
Instagram.
We're everywhere. Super Gamecast 64, that's my podcast. We love you guys. We'll see you soon. Goodbye, Facebook. And as always, Twitch, you guys get a little bit of extra. Because, you know, we love you. And we will see you guys later. Bye!